Has to make a living, right? You see, I'm a beggar by trade. Patch is the beggar, that's me. Glad to meet you, glad to meet you. How do you do? How do you do? Now, I know what you're thinking. Why doesn't a person as bright and charming and, well, good-looking as yours truly get an honest job? Why, if it wasn't for me, just think of all the leftover diamond rings and dollar bills you'd have cluttering up your attic. Now, most people confuse a beggar with a bum. A bum is a lazy sort, tattered and torn and often unwashed. Well, my clothes may be tattered and torn just a bit, but they're carefully chosen and clean as a pin. And a bum is a taker through and through, but a beggar's a giver, a lover of life. I'll give you a song, a dance, or even a rhyme. I'll make your day sunny, your evening sublime. That was a rhyme, did you notice? And all I ask in return for my smiles is a small contribution, your leftover goods. A penny.
But a penny saved is a penny earned.
That is a lesson you haven't learned.
A nickel.
A nickel for you?
Don't be absurd. Tens and tons of you haven't heard.
A dollar?
A dollar? Why do you ask for four? A small fee?
Sorry, old chap. That's the way it must be.
A dime.
A dime is something I just cannot spare.
Now off with you. Go. Get out of our hair.
A diamond.
A diamond what? Surely you jest.
A diamond indeed. What a test.
An emerald?
An emerald is just too high a price.
This neighborhood used to be so nice.
Or maybe a smile?
A smile? What? Who has time for a smile?
The common people who have no style.
Well, yes, a giggle is payment enough, for the best contribution comes straight from the heart. For a penny, I'll tell you a story, my friend. That's what you came here for, isn't it, sir? So, open your purse strings. It's a beautiful day. I'm Patches the Beggar, and I'm on my way. Now, who has a penny? A penny for Patches.
Yes, a penny's all I ask, and I'm really asking if too many of you have a penny.
Come on, hurry, you lot. We mustn't be late, for Patches is just around the corner, I'm sure.
Look! It's Patches!
Where?
In the back!
Working hard!
And look at that face!
A smile's what I see. Has Patches been lucky?
Let's find out!
I really want to know. Oh, Patches!
Oh, Patches!
Who's calling?
It's us, your friends, your students, and live.
Your neighbors are here and right on time.
So you are, sublime and on time and all with the rhyme. I'm coming, my friends, with news, great news. I've made a new friend in the middle, you see. A man with a smile and a penny for me. How rude. How embarrassed I am, for I haven't introduced you to my students and friends. Yes, these are my pupils, the best in the lot of the Patches
Academy of Fame with Style.
And leading the group is my best number two. My able assistant, Young Rags, is his name. So quickly, politely, a bow from you all to our audience, dear.
You heard him, beggars, a bow to our friends.
Now, quickly, on to the business with hand. I've had a success. A penny is ours. We leave tonight.
Yeah!
And how about you? Your day on the streets has been fruitful, I trust?
We begged and we begged, but it just didn't pay.
Nothing.
But nothing.
We had a bad day.
The streets are full of people, it's true.
But no one would listen.
So watch us dance.
Our stories were completely wasted, and so are our songs.
I'm tired and hungry.
I just want to go home.
Oh, why the long faces? I'm Patches, the master, simply the best. Of the beggars, that is. And thanks to our generous new friend in the middle,
hi!
We'll have supper tonight.
Yay!
Some rice, perhaps. A piece of stale bread. A cup of warm water. A yummy fish head.
Yeah!
Another rhyme, did you notice?
We noticed all right, didn't we, friend?
friends.
I'm tired of rice!
And I hate fish heads!
I want a roast turkey and a cup of warm milk!
A donut with chocolate!
Ooh. And strawberry cake!
Ah. With lots of whipped cream!
Easy. I'm tired of wanting! And wanting some more!
I don't want one anymore!
Yeah!
You're right, my friends. I'm forced to agree. Our sad tale begins, for doing her chores, and endless they were, is the star of our show, a poor little orphan whose name you all know. You know her name, don't you? So tell us all just what her name is. Well, perfect, you're right, for this is the story of Cinderella! An echo, how odd. Well, I've heard the story dozens of times, but I'll stay here to help tell it again, for I never grow tired of the magical, tragical, comical tale of Cinderella!
Cinderella, Cinderella, why haven't you finished your chores, you lazy thing? Cinderella, close the door! My food's getting cold!
Yes, really.
Oh, really?
I mean, really?
Now come close, my girls, for we need to talk. Not to you. I'll talk to my own daughters. Thank you.
But I am.
You are her stepdaughter, and now that your father is gone,
you must mind your place.
Yes, Mother.
Mother?
I mean, stepmother.
And now, my darlings, this may be the most important year of your life, for at long last, the prince.
Oh, charming, the prince.
Oh, baby, the prince.
The prince has come home from abroad, and tonight a ball will be given so that every girl in the kingdom may meet the prince, for he must choose a bride.
Hip, hip, hooray!
Hip, hip, hooray!
Hip, hip!
Hip, hip! Hip, hip, hooray!
Your stepmother went shopping just this morning and bought the most beautiful gowns and frou-frou and frills to make her girls look perfect. At least, that's the plan.
The prince will be enchanted.
Won't he, girl?
Yes, mother.
Yes, mother.
Yes, mother.
Mother?
I mean, stepmother.
They can't rely on beauty alone. You might just remind them to show off their charm, their sweetness, their wit.
No problem for my girls. Don't you agree?
Yes, mother.
Yes, mother.
Yes.
Now, you'd better prepare, for the day has grown late, and the time for the ball will soon be upon us, and you'll need some help.
Cinderella? Cinderella! Cinderella, where are you?
I'm your stepmother!
Come, help me get to my beautiful gown.
Cinderella, help me lace this corset.
How can I go to the ball if my gown doesn't fit? Hurry, hurry!
Cinderella, you lazy thing! Come help me warm up to the prince! Hurry, hurry!
Cinderella, help me button my dress!
Cinderella, I need you! I can't find my shoe!
Cinderella, come quickly!
Cinderella, where are you? Cinderella, where are you?
Cinderella, when I call you, I want you to come immediately. Now here, help me fix this. Ouch! Clumsy!
Lovely.
What?
My darling, just look at your hair and beauty.
Yo!
Your curls must hang so.
Cinderella, fasten this pin, this tie, this button, her hanky, her gloves, her purse, her shoes. Isn't it awful?
Yes! Awful she is!
And clumsy and rude!
Hurry, Cinderella, run, run, run!
You'll make us late! Yes, late for the ball!
Then she looked at her darlings. They were nearly ready to go, all thanks to Cinderella.
Beauty, sit sweetly, and lovely, pull in your tummy. Feet together, girls. Knees too. At the same time.
Then she took a long look and felt in her bones that one of her girls would catch the eye of the prince that night, and they would live in the royal castle for life.
Lovely, stop scratching. And Beauty, don't rub your nose, for the time has come. We're ready to go.
Oh, Mother, do I really look perfect indeed?
Perfect story.
Perfect. Almost.
This is her lovely daughter. She loves her just as she ought her.
My daughter is young and beautiful.
She's ravishing. She makes me sing. She's everything the star could bring, except for one little thing. Her nose, it grows. The length of it varies. It frightens canaries.
But
still she is young and beautiful. She's ravishing. She makes me think she's everything the sword could bring, except for one little thing. Her chin, chagrin. You've heard of a double, it's triple, that's trouble.
But
still she is young and beautiful. She's ravishing. She makes me think she's everything the sword could bring, except for one little thing. Her ears, my dears, they're pink and they're jumbo, they're borrowed from Dumbo.
But
still she is young and beautiful. She's ravishing. She makes me say she's everything the sword could bring. Cha-la, cha-la, tra-la-la-la-la-la.
Girl!
And what of me, Mother? Aren't I really a sight?
A vision, my dear.
But with one tiny flaw.
This is her lovely daughter. She loves her just as she ought her.
My doctor is young and beautiful.
She's ravishing. She makes me think she's everything the store could bring, except for one little thing. Her tooth, uncouth, it's green and it's fuzzy, oh, slimy and scuzzy.
But
still, and beautiful. She's ravishing. She makes me think she's everything the store could bring. Except for one little thing. Her hair, it's rare, it's wild, and it's really a dilly.
But
still she is young and beautiful. She's ravishing. She makes me think she's everything the store could bring. Except for one little thing. Her skin, a sin, it's gray, it's spotted, and all polka dotted.
What?
Still, she is young and beautiful. She's ravishing. She's ravishing. She's ravishing. She makes me think she's everything the store could bring. Tra-la.
Tra-la.
Tra-la-la-la-la-la. Tra-la!
Tra-la!
Tra-la-la-la-la-la!
The time is here. You must come at once. But where is the carriage?
The carriage?
The carriage?
Cinderella, the carriage, miserable girl!
It's waiting, so Mother, just outside the door.
Why didn't you say so, you ridiculous child? Come along, girls.
Mother, my corset's too tight. I simply can't breathe.
Mother, my feet hurt. These shoes are too small.
Now off you go, girls, and remember to smile.
Don't they look lovely?
Who asked you?
Stepmother dear, can I help you in the carriage?
You certainly may not.
She probably doesn't want you to stick your head out of the door lest anyone should see the soot on your nose. A scandal, an outrage, that's what you are.
Now go scrub your face.
I know. I'll bake a nice pumpkin pie for you when you return.
Yes, to help celebrate our victory, for by midnight tonight, one of my girls will capture the heart of the handsome young prince. Don't just stand there, Cinderella! Bake that pie!
I'm coming, girls! Here comes Mama!
Pumpkin pie. Well, Cinderella's pumpkin pie sounded delicious, and perhaps there might be a small piece of crust left over for her new friend, Patches. And baking always made the house smell so good. It was really no reason to complain, even though she wouldn't ride in a royal coach. Even though she wouldn't be escorted up the palace steps through the courtyard and into the grand ballroom. Even though she wouldn't get to see the lords and ladies in their finest evening clothes. Even though the prince wouldn't come to her and ask her for a dance. Oh my, Cinderella drew me again, and there's so much work to do. Shame on you, Cinderella. Now, off you go to the pumpkin patch to fetch some pumpkins for a delicious pumpkin pie.
What's all that ruckus?
Cleo?
What are you doing, you two? Stop chasing each other!
There's no reason you two shouldn't be friends. Now, shake hands and smile at each other, and I'll let you come with me to the pumpkin patch while I take a little nap. Come on now, Cleo. That's it, Fido. There, see how easy that is?
Oh, no! Don't do that! Don't do that! Cleo, you come back! You come back! Stop it!
My, you two should be ashamed. But hurry along now, for Cinderella will soon arrive. I just hope we don't see any dog catchers on the way. Oh, Fido, I was only kidding. Besides, there are lots of dogs near the pumpkin patch. Oh, Cleo, don't you run away. Oh, well, it's not very far to that pumpkin patch, filled with cute little pumpkins. In fact, here we are now. Where are you, my pumpkin friends?
Here we are, honey.
Are you sure?
Yeah.
Are you sure you're sure?
Aww.
Oh, I'm so glad. And now, join me in a nap, for Cinderella will soon arrive.
I have no time to lose. I must choose the perfect pumpkin for a yummy pumpkin pie. I'll choose that one, or that one, or this one looks nice, or this one's bigger than the rest.
I think this one looks by far the best.
Oh, it does indeed. It's really quite...
Oh! I'm sorry I startled you. There's no reason to be afraid. Patches the beggar at your service. I was there in the corner taking a nap in the shade of that big orange pumpkin.
Oh, I didn't mean to disturb you.
Oh, it's nothing, my dear, for I much prefer the company of a lovely young lady to the dream I was dreaming of rich pumpkin pie.
But wait, I'm confused. Why are you here in the pumpkin patch when, alas, you should be on your way to the ball, the prince's great ball, where I've been told that tonight he will choose a wife, a bride of his own. I'm sure if he saw you, his heart would fall. He'd make you the belle of the ball. What a rhyme, what a rhyme.
Me? At the ball. Well, I'm just a cellar girl, a sweeper of ashes, a baker of pies.
A dreamer of dreams?
Well, I must confess I've had a few, but dreams are just wishes. They never come true.
Oh, but that's where you're wrong, my dear, for dreams are just wishes, and wishes come true if properly wished. Now, I know you've been wishing for days and days that your stepmother would, in her kindness, allow you to attend the ball, but you're afraid she would laugh at the thought of it all.
And I suppose she's right. Or surely these rags would never be allowed within the palace doors.
And you need a coach, a great royal coach, for the castle is over the hill and beyond. It's too far to walk without any shoes. Upon arrival, you'd have the ballroom blues.
Oh my, it seems useless, even to wish.
Oh, again, you're not right. For wishes, you see, can solve any problem. Now, I have a plan. Forget about the pumpkins. Go back to the house. For there, in just moments, I promise to send someone to help you. A magical friend!
Oh, Patches.
Oh, don't bother to thank me. Now, time's a-wasting. The evening's not young, and the prince will soon be dancing with the ladies at court. And from their ranks, you will choose his bride.
Well, I suppose it can't hurt. I have so much to do to tidy the house, and I'll wish while I'm sleeping a nice compromise.
Off you go, Cinderella. And remember, wishes always come true if wished from the heart. Well, I promised your help. I'd best get to work. I'll call upon my friend Raggedy Annie. She'll know what to do. Oh, Annie! Come quickly! There's work to do! Come, Annie, hurry! There's chores to be done! Annie, where are you? Oh, don't let me down!
Here I am, Patches! Oh. Now what's so important? You see, I was snoozing, my friend. You woke me. Now I'm just tired and exhausted from baby all day. This better be good, Patches, old junk.
It's very important. I found a new friend, and she needs our help. It's young Cinderella, and she has a dream.
Well, dreams and wishes are my specialty. That's true. Now tell me, Patches, just what can I do?
Nice rhyme.
Thank you.
Now, quickly, go to the top of the hill. Go to the big house. Go through the back door and down into the cellar. There you will find Cinderella, and she will be working, no doubt. She'll tell you her story, explain what she wants. Now off you go, Annie, for help her, you must.
I'll do what I can, Patches. You don't have to. Please, you owe me a favor, but I shall succeed.
I'll not forget. Annie. Cinderella's that way.
Okay. I knew that.
A favor for Annie. Now what should I do?
I have an idea just looking at you. I'll make her a treat we can share with a sigh. I'll bake a delicious pumpkin pie.
Now everyone loves apple and coconut's a dream. Or how about huckleberry with mountains of ice cream? But they are not my favorite, I cannot tell a lie. For nothing's quite as yummy as a
pumpkin pie!
Oh, pumpkin pie!
Pumpkin pie!
It's time for Christmas dinner.
And guess what's for dessert?
Now gather in a circle. I'm gonna make a wish. I wish that all you pumpkins were in a baking dish. I'd mush you up and squish you and stir you all around and pop you in the oven till you're
golden brown.
Oh, pumpkin pie.
Pumpkin pie.
Pumpkin pie.
Pumpkin pie.
Nothing suits my tummy like a white whipped cream. I put you on the counter and let you sit a while. With sweet anticipation, I would wait and smile. And then while I was waiting, I'd take a little nap. If someone tried to taste you, their pinkies I would slap. I'd snooze a little longer, and then by and by, tummy would be ready for
pumpkin pie.
Oh, pumpkin pie.
Pumpkin pie.
Pumpkin pie.
Pumpkin pie.
Nothing suits my tummy
like a pumpkin pie.
Whoa, 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 pumpkin pie.
Pumpkin pie.
Pumpkin pie.
Pumpkin pie.
Nothing's quite as yummy
as a pumpkin pie.
I pour a glass of milk, then before nothing else would do, I get a big sharp knife out and tiptoe up to you. I raise that big sharp knife right over your head. Hey, where are you going? Is it something that I said? Now I was only kidding, don't worry yourself. I'll put that great sharp knife right back on the kitchen shelf. You're all my friends, I love you, and I will tell you why. For someday you are gonna be
a pumpkin pie.
Whoa, pumpkin pie.
Pumpkin pie.
Pumpkin pie.
Pumpkin pie.
Nothing suits my tummy like a pumpkin pie. Whoa, pumpkin pie.
Pumpkin pie.
Pumpkin pie.
Pumpkin pie.
Nothing's quite as yummy as a pumpkin
pie.
A wonderful idea, for soon all the swells and rich people will arrive just primed for some begging. We'll beg and we'll plead, we'll get down on our knees, for pennies and dollars we'll even say,
please!
What a rhyme, what a rhyme. Now, off you go, beggars. Young Rags and I will stop to see Cinderella, then meet you at the palace gate.
Oh, so much to do, and so little time to do it. The house will be clean and tidy, spick and span before
Oh, how Cinderella wished she could go to the ball and see all the magnificent lords and ladies in their finest evening clothes. How she wished she could see the king in a great ruby crown and, of course, the prince.
She would watch as he asked lady after lady to dance with him. Then finally, he would go to her. He would bow deeply and smile and say, "My lady, I would be honored if you would waltz with me."
"Oh, yes, your highness."
And Cinderella would take the hand of the prince and waltz off into the night. In the corner of the great hall, her stepmother and stepsisters would gaze with envy. But this is the cellar and not the great hall. And surely a broom is not a prince. So Cinderella went back to work, but not for long.
My turn, Patches?
Now's the time, Annie. Come on, Rags, let's catch up with the beggars before they make a wrong turn.
But you'll stick around and maybe just join the fun?
Happy to help. Oh, what's out?
Oh! Why, dear Cinderella, don't look so startled.
Who are you? I must be dreaming.
Who am I? Who am I?
I am, you see.
I know! You must be my fairy godmother. I've read about fairy godmothers in all of the fairy tales.
Fairy godmother?
Sounds good to me.
Yes, dear, that's who I am. I'm your fairy godmother. Now tell me, dear Cinderella, what's a fairy godmother?
What's a fairy godmother?
No fair. I asked you first.
Why, she's a magical friend that shows up just in time to fulfill all your magical dreams. And dreams are important, for how else would we know what to wish for?
Why, that's a very handsome broom.
And it dances very well.
And I'm very embarrassed.
But you mustn't be, Cinderella. Why, what do you think every girl who's not at the ball tonight is doing? She's wishing and dreaming that she were there.
Now, why aren't you at the ball?
Well, someone had to tidy up the house.
If you were her, what would you do?
Well, I just leave this house. I just leave.
Yeah, they make you work harder than any servant. If you wanted to be a servant, you could go somewhere else and be paid very well.
Well, you see, I couldn't leave my stepmother. She married my father, and I promised him before he died that I'd take care of her. Oh, I wish you were here now. There I go, wishing and dreaming again.
But wishes are important. What are you wishing for right now?
Oh, it's silly.
Come, dear, tell us.
Well, do you see that great big pumpkin way back there in the back of the patch?
She stumbled over it in the dark. She nearly squashed it.
Well, as the moon shines on it now, I wish that the pumpkin could transform into a great royal coach that would just escort me to the ball.
But a coach needs horses.
Field mice, perhaps, could turn into beautiful white horses.
Oh, I don't think so, dear. To tell the truth, I'm terrified of mice.
Well, and what of a coachman and a footman for your magical pumpkin coach?
Well, the old dog and the alley cat.
Cats and dogs? I'm not crazy about them either.
I'll call them, and perhaps they'll come.
Oh, Cleo! Oh, Fido!
You two!
Call them? No, wait!
Spiders give me the heebie-jeebies. Rattlesnakes, they
guy like you.
One more time!
Nothing to fear.
I'm feeling I'm bored. Yawn, yawn, ho-hum.
Just look at this crowd. I'm so glad we've come.
Come, come, let's go get out of our way.
Now, don't be upset. It's a special day.
Of course you look special. Don't make such a fuss.
Why, thank you, Prince. So it's so glad to be us.
How glad it is to be here at the castle.
I do hate this crowd. It's such a hassle.
What a hassle of the parking today. It would have been fine if you tipped the valet.
I tip my hat to the prince. What a ball.
He shall find his princess once and for all.
And as they arrive, the moment's at hand for a royal announcement from the town criers themselves.
Eerie!
The moment has arrived.
You can hear the bells ring.
The ball is beginning.
And here comes the king.
Here comes the king! Here comes the king! Here comes the king! Here comes the king! Whoa!
Get back to work!
How do you do? How do you do?
There goes the king! There goes the king! There goes the king! There goes the king! Whoa!
All right, beggars, to work at once. We'll make enough money to eat 4 months. Scrambled eggs and ham, a weenie roast with raisin toast and boysenberry jam. A pizza pie would satisfy my tummy's tiny hurt. Kentucky Fried Chicken is finger licking and good for my dessert.
Oh, please, sir, I want a nickel. I'll dance and sing, I'll make a rhyme. I'll dance a ballet, I'll sing an opera. I'll give you both for one thin dime. Oh, please, sir. I will gladly strike a pose if you will bring me half a dollar so I can buy some clothes.
A coat that's new, a vest that's blue with buttons made of gold. A lacy collar that costs a dollar and isn't 10 years old. A hat of silk that's white as milk with blue, but pink and red. With perfect hair the prince would wear the day that he is led. My feet look good in shoes of wood with buckles painted green. With socks of cotton that aren't rotten, especially where they're seen.
Oh, please, sir, I want a nickel. I'll dance and sing, I'll make a rhyme. I'll dance a ballet, I'll sing an opera. I'll give you both for one thin dime. Oh, please, sir, I need a nickel. Oh, can't you see I'm blue? For just a quarter.
There'll be no supper tonight.
Captain? Oh, Cinderella, you're lovely indeed. Oh, and this is Rags. He's my number two.
Patches said it. You're lovely, and how do you do?
Lovely, but nervous. What's grinding you?
I can say the wrong things. I mean, all the wrong things. I must learn how to behave with the lords and ladies at court.
Heaven forbid.
Pardon?
I said, the heavens are lovely tonight, my lady. Just look at those stars.
Oh, they're sparkling and twinkling as I've never seen them before. But perhaps that's just because I'm so happy.
Happy? But why?
I'm going to my first ball with my first ball gown and my first pair of shoes.
And let those shoes carry you to the ball, lovely lady.
Oh.
But you came here to meet the prince.
Yes, and I just hope that he is as kind and caring as you guys.
And handsome!
Handsome. Handsome indeed.
All right, enough, Cinderella. You're off to your bait. You're off to the ball. Rags and I would love to escort you, but I'm afraid we can't, for we're just beggars and we look out of place on the palace floor.
Oh, but
Cinderella.
Cinderella,
we can't tell you where and we can't tell you when, but we'll make you a promise.
We will meet again.
Now, on to the climax, the high point of the play, the most exciting point of the day. Now, for the part of the prince, the actor must be someone who's truly appealing, you see. Now who can I find to play such a part? And you know I must hurry, for the ball will soon start. The actor must be someone handsome and wise. Hey, I noticed the actor. A little surprise. Tomorrow he'd find his bride.
Whatever you say, sonny boy.
And after the ball, all the citizens returned to their homes to revel in memories of the glorious event. There were so many people, so many swells.
Yes, thousands were there.
Oh, yes, indeed.
Thousands, at least.
And the ballroom was beautiful, decorated just so with music for dancing.
Of course, we danced for hours with the prince.
Yes, danced for hours.
Oh, hours at least. And of course, we knew nearly everyone there.
Everyone.
Nearly.
except for one girl who arrived very late. Who she was a mystery to all.
Did she dance with the prince?
Well, I think I saw her dance with him once.
Do you think he liked her?
Oh, my, no.
She was there only shortly. And
he practically chased her away.
And you, Cinderella, did you work very late?
Just right till after midnight.
And you slept soundly, I hope?
Yeah, just wishing and dreaming that I was there.
Oh, nothing could be as wonderful as being there. It was perfect, delightful.
And not only that, I'm certain when the prince decides to choose his bride, he'll seek one of your stepsisters. They are high on his list.
But how he'll choose between them, I don't really know.
My lovely, my beauty, soon one of you will be the bride of the prince. Don't you agree?
Yes, mother.
It's me.
It's this girl, of course.
I know he'll choose me.
Either one.
But you're too lovely.
And you butter finger.
Throw. Go off to your rooms for a long beauty sleep, and when after your nap, a nice pumpkin pie.
Yummy.
Yes, stepmother, I'll just get that.
Her back.
for coming from far and near. Yes, you have come from far and wide to be with the prince and his beautiful bride. For a wedding present to his loving wife, he gave her himself, he gave her his life, and we shall give her something more. You see, we have a surprise in store. Happiness is something that no one should miss. So we have some plans for more wedded bliss. You know the child frightens, they weep and they moan. The reason's because they're always alone. They snivel and cry each side by side. Now what they need, my friends, is a bride. Each needs a bride that's special indeed to share in their lives. Yes, that's what they need. So here are two ladies to share in your lives.
Cinderella's stepsisters will be your wife.
To share his kingly life. Now what the king really needs is a brand new wife.
And the perfect bride for my dear old pot, none other than my stepfather-in-law.
So everyone giggle, yes, everyone smile, for tomorrow they'll all walk down the aisle. The news is wondrous, the news is great, but enough of this talking, let's all celebrate. At the banquet tonight, we'll each always sigh, but we'll leave room for delicious
pumpkin pie!